I'm speaking to Mrs. Kala Prakash, a Sindhi writer based in Adipur in Gujarat. Kala Prakash has been with the Adipur Indian Institute of Sindhology for several years now and working with children, trying to introduce them to the Sindhi culture that seems to be quickly disappearing. Mrs. Prakash, could you first tell us something about your own life and your experiences as somebody who has been through partition and the kind of impact it made, your experiences?
See, when we went to Karachi, 47, I was only 14 or something. So we were very small to understand exactly what is happening. We have got the freedom, this we could understand. Because being that small, young also, we used to go in the processions and all that and say, Britishers quit India and all that we saw. And we joined those processions also as children. But then suddenly we are leaving Karachi for what and why we are going to Bombay. That we had no VM. What's happening? Just our parents packed up and said that we are not safe here now. Karachi doesn't belong to us now. Now let's go. So the only thing at that time, as 13, 14 years at that age, we could feel only that we are leaving our friends. We are leaving the land. That pain troubled us later when we grew up. That when we were in the steamer from Karachi to Bombay, in the steamer, what I was thinking that maybe after 2 days we will go back to Karachi. We are not going permanently, not leaving Sindh permanently. But when we came and saw that we have to be here permanently and our old friends will never meet us now. And we were that small and nobody knew where we are going. We had no postal addresses to give to each other also that we can contact. So at that time the last was of the friends. But later, after when we graduated, when we went to college and all that, we realized that no, we have lost something much bigger than that. Friends are okay. New friends also we can get, and by that time we had friendships many. But from where the land will come from? So we can't. Moreover, we can't go back to Karachi. I can't see that Rambagh again. We used to live near Rambagh. That was the time of movement. India was fighting for freedom. Right. So all those patriotic feelings we used to share with one another. And play also, because our age was such, not that we were very much worried about the freedom, but that today Gandhi is fasting, that this thing has happened, that Nehru has gone to jail. All those things were very dominant factors. And we friends used to talk about it and play a lot also. And go to Rambagh in the evening at 5, 6 o'clock and come back at 9 o'clock home. So that roaming about and meeting friends, that loss was very great. But later that loss of land, you see, troubled us a lot. It started bothering us that we are no landless people. There is nothing, there is no land in India that we can call our own.
How did this impact the writing? How did this impact Sindhi writing and your own writing in particular?
Writing actually came to me later, at the age of something like 20. I fell in love with a class fellow. So in his friendship only, I went to that literary circle every Saturday and started writing there. That
what is
how.
Otherwise,
yes.
So what kind of writing did you do at that time? The themes of partition never come into that writing?
At that time, mostly I think the trend that was prevailing in all languages was actually the classless society. There should be no rich and poor, no small and big. We struggled for classless society. And mostly, I mean, that used to be labeled as Marxism or communism or whatever. But that type of poetry and stories used to be written. But particular, if you ask me, I have been since my beginning writing more about human relationships, rather than social reforms or classless society and all that. And among, you could have interacted with several Sindhi writers.
Many, many. At least every Saturday, at least 40 of us in Bombay, we will meet from 4 to 7. Every Saturday. We wouldn't go anywhere. Those days we all had financial problems. We had no money to go to films or party or this or that. I used to work at Ballot Pier. So from Ballot Pier and everybody from their work would rush to Peter Road, where Professor Mangaram Malkani used to reside. Professor Mangaram Uttaram Malkani, he was a great dramatist and a great writer. There he provided a space and a large table and some 40, 50 chairs and a cup of tea also, with his expenditure. That we used to enjoy very much. When we reach, we will get a cup of tea and then we start reading whatever I have written. I'll read a story and the criticism will come from other writers.
And which year was this?
It was 49, 48, 49. Some four, five years continuously that Andhravi class ran. After that, after Mangaram Malkani left for Calcutta.
Have you seen a change in Sindhi writing over these years from 1949 to today?
A lot of change. The new generation that has come up, they are more individualistic. As we used to say, life, literature for life. But they say no, art for art's sake. And in their writings, it is more the individual's pain rather than the pain of the society. Of course, individual is part of society, and the reflections come. Unknowingly, they are portraying the society only, if you go to see. Because whatever joy or pain I'm getting, I'm not alone. I'm surrounded by family, neighborhood, and whatnot,
right.
Workplace. So ultimately, not that it was totally individualistic, but they insisted that the individual is more important. And not the society, or not the social change, or not the social reform. And we are not, writers are not expected to be reformists. If you write with the sophistication, and that you dip your pen in the blood, so that really comes out a real piece of art. It is not necessary to think case mein se samaj ka bhala hoga ya nahi hoga. That is not necessary. We have not to worry about that. I just should get this freedom.
And this is true of Sindhi writing today, particularly?
It is still same, but with the vigor it came, now I think it is balanced.
How would you describe the state of contemporary Sindhi literature? Would you say it is robust? Would you say it is in a state of decline?
No, it is surely. Literature is surely in the state of decline.
Literature as a whole?
Yeah. Literature is surely, because we have no readers. I am telling you that mostly only there is a group of writers spread all over India. And we are the writers, and that group of say 100-150 writers, Sindhi writers all over India, we are reading one another's books. Hardly an outsider you will get who will tell you that he has read your book. It is very, how can you blame them also? They all are going to government schools. They don't know Arabic script, so they are not to be blamed. How can they read also?
But how did it get to a point when you're saying there are literally 100-150 people writing for each other in the last 60 years since independence?
No, the number has been declining gradually. In 50, we had readers. Publisher, get a book printed and it will be finished within a month or so.
In the 50s?
Yes, but not now. Now you don't get a buyer. Now that Sindhi writer gets the book published from his own pocket and sends to all the writers, spends that postal expenditure also from his own pocket, and then writers may also acknowledge or not, that is also not expected, much expected. Now the things are very bad.
And what would you say about the quality of this writing that is happening? Because I'm getting conflicting views on this.
No, quality is good. quality is surely improved. We have grown. Mostly you see the young people are whatever they are calling themselves leaving a few, suppose a new generation, say another 150 have come to, but hardly say 25-30 are real, given the real matter. Otherwise whatever is coming into, we don't enjoy. We the last generation people, we don't like it much because there is no, that spirit is not there.
I was speaking to some writers and they said there's more depth to Drew's writing.
Yes. They have become writers for sake of, I don't know, they may be connected with some organization, are attending some seminars and this thing. So, chalo, ye bhi share karna hai, to mujhe bhi share karna hai. So, whatever, whether it is appreciated or not, that also, Jadis got there, they will come and read anything. And as I say, exceptions are there. Some, of course, good from next generation also. Actually, this is the third generation. After partition, this is not the next, but the next to next. So now, strong feeling for the human suffering, or even that strong feeling for the human relationship is not depicted much.
But I remember speaking to Kopati Hiranandani about this, and she said that the problem was that Sindhis were uprooted from their land. There was no linkage to the land. And once that is lost, the culture will gradually disappear. So would you agree with that?
Kopati's days, she was 100% right. She was a Vijayanagari. She was a great lady. But now the things have changed. Now it has become a trend to present Sindhi drama and cultural shows, especially on Cheti Chand, that Sindhi is a new year. So people are organizing every town, village, city you will find that on Cheti Chand. There is a big mela, and there they stage Sindhi drama, they have Sindhi music program, they call singers from outside also, other cities also, and that is how at least now that vocal culture is strong.
The traditional vocal culture, the bhagats, is that still alive?
Yes, but still it is there. I cannot name now, but a few groups have come up.
And so poetry is, you're saying the drama is very robust. What about other forms of Sindhi literature? What about
novels? Novel writing is poor, I must say. I mean, not much. Fewer writing, very few. I mean, you can count them on fingers. Out of those elder generation, the first generation after partition, whosoever we are, I mean, how many we are, 100 or 150, whatever. I think some 10 people are writing novels. And Baki, other branches, okay. Shastra is also quite enough. And poetry is in excess, I must say.
Poetry is?
In excess.
In excess?
Yes. Why because it has become very easy. You have not to follow any rule of poetry. You need not to write. Just in 2 pages, you sit for 15 minutes and write something. And you say it's a poem. And it is accepted, published also. You can say in Mushara also. I think it has become very convenient to write poetry these days.
But who is publishing all this?
Very few magazines are there. We have Rachna here. Sindhology is taking out Rachna. And one very good literary magazine, Sipu, Thakur Chawla in Bombay. They are the heirs of Ram Panjwani, Professor Ram Panjwani, who was a professor in Jain College. You must have heard of Sindhi Kitabana.
I've been there.
So Thakur Paru are running Sipu. That is a very good literary magazine. And Rachna here. And Indwasi every weekly, that Indwasi is being
printed. So some poems come and are printed in Hindi also. And some like Sindhi association in West Bengal, Central Railway in Bombay. All the people are having circles, Sindhi circles in their government offices or private firms or whatever. So annual magazines are 6 monthly, they are also taken. But Punja is there, a very important magazine.
So would you say that these all these different magazines, they have any kind of impact on today's writing? Or would you say that there's just small pockets, each one doing their own little thing?
Small pocket. Impact on Sindhi life or a general impact, if you want to say. No, we don't have readers. We don't have readers.
Are you talking about Sindhi writing in the Persian Arabic script, or would you say that the
Devanagari? Even Devanagari. I have those people who supported Devanagari and started writing and getting the book published. You ask them, if they are honest, they will tell you that even there is no sale of their books also. If people are not interested in Sindhi book, they will better go for an English book or an English magazine. Even hundreds of girls in Bombay, you will see who are working, will carry a Femina or something, not a Sindhi magazine. Have you seen any Sindhi lady carrying a Sindhi magazine? We read magazines in the local train. So when we come back from the work, I used to work at Balakya. So mere hath mein toh hoti thi, magar I never saw any lady, Sindhi lady. And they will carry Femina or Illustrated Weekly or whatever, but not a Sindhi magazine. This is really a pity, but no, nothing can be done about it. But only awakening that has come, that is also an awakening or a passion or a trend, I don't know. In India as well as overseas, wherever Sindhis are there, they are celebrating Cheti Chandra with the great Dhammaka. And they are calling singers from India and other places also, paying them well and getting good audience, so that our vocal culture is saved by this.
Who would you say today are the important Sindhi writers? Who are the people making a difference? Would be remembered once on a cylinder.
One was Kishan Katwani, who expired some 5 years ago. Kishan Katwani is a novelist. He was a novelist and a story writer. A few free verses also he wrote. That we lost him. Then there was Govan Mali, we lost him also. He was a novelist. He wrote about 24 novels, I think. Mali. Then there is Kirat Babani. Now he has stopped writing. He is, I think, very aged and cannot write. But he has written very beautiful stories and some free verses also. Not novel. Novel Sambrat, we used to, Mali, we used to call novels. Govan Mali.
The names that you are mentioning are
Harim Thani from Ajmer, Govardhan Mehbubani, he also expired recently. A very good poet, a very good dramatist, a very good prose writer also. Then you find many here in Sindhology, all of them are writers of good merit.
Many of the writers you have referred to are people that we have used.
Yeah, Kirat Babani is there, Prabhu Vaffa is there in Bombay. He is 90 plus, Papa Saab. We had Dukhail and Vilgir here, very great poets. Those also we have lost. Well, after reaching here only, we attended their funerals. But I was feeling thankful to God that I came to Adipur and I could see these great men of letters. Dukhail and Vilgir, both were great poets.
When did you come to Adipur?
2002. What? Before that, we were 25 years, we were in Dubai, actually, but we are Bombaytis. We have a home at Bombay, in Chandrapur, where my son is born with his wife and children. But we came here especially because my husband wanted some work. He said after working so hard, he got retired at the age of 71 also. In Dubai, people were not living. He was a principal there of Indian Army. So then they got somebody and we came to do so much work and suddenly we without work. In Bombay is traveling is very difficult. Places are very far of where to go and what to do. But here, Sindhology was there. He got the work.
That is why we came and settled here. Otherwise, we would have been in Bombay.
Right. You've been talking about all these writers who are now being lost to us. What do you think needs to be done to, you know, bring the new generation of writers or potential writers into the
potential writers? I think one thing I realize that it should come from within. It's if people may not agree or agree. I don't know how you feel about it, but it's a God's gift. You may start writing at a certain age. You don't know, you already something was there within you, but you couldn't write up to the age of 50. After that also you can start writing. There is no age limit. Kabhi bhi aap likh sakte hain. Like Rita Shahani, one in Pune, she started writing from the age of 50. There is one other lady, Tara Michanani in Pune. She wrote very good novels, but now she is not writing, going only to satsangs. She says, no, I don't feel like writing. So this generation mein prose writers to mujhe to bahut kam, very less.
But does it also have to do with the fact that there is very little education happening in Sindhi? Very few colleges are teaching Sindhi.
That is a great loss. There is no Sindhi medium in schools as a subject also. Many colleges have stopped, even in Ullasnagar township, like Ullasnagar, how many students are there who are taking Sindhi? There are very few. I have worked in RKT College. When I was there, at least in first year, some 60-70 students used to be there. Today I am hearing that even first year has having hardly 10-15 students. Or MA or whatever in Sindhi language, but where are the students? Those who are doing that, they are openly telling the teachers, their professors, that they do it because they will get increase in pay where they are working. If double graduate ho jaoge na, to salary badhegi. Do it in Sindhi or whatever, so because MA degree is there. Now, if one or two students are coming, taking entire Sindhi in MA, no, that is only for the purpose of financial benefit, but for the sake of literature, MA full means six papers in Sindhi, how much you must study, how many authors and all. But then they just take notes from their professors and just write and pass like that. There are no really keen students that we have, that we expect that they will become scholars or tomorrow they will. I don't think any such thing is going to happen.
Do you think this also has to do with the fact that the world is increasingly becoming very, you know, international, very global? India is being exposed to a lot of global culture.
I have heard that this is the position in all languages. Unfortunately, I don't read non-Sindhi literature much, except English magazines here or there. I don't claim, so I can't say, but I attended in one function in Bombay once, my confined chambers are, I don't know where. There this topic came, but some good learned people, 200 Sindhis had gathered. There also, I think they were giving awards to Sindhi writers also, but they hadn't read their books. Award dete hain, theek hai, achhi baat hai. But you see, the real award for the writer is that he should have readers. Right. To give me 25,000 to do for a book. Okay, I will spend money is also needed. But if I have 25 good readers who communicate with me or who can criticize me or who can praise me or whatever, that will be more rewarding for me actually as a writer, if you ask me. 25,000 doesn't matter, you see. It can be earned from any other source also. So readers should be there, no? Who have really read. And this is my personal experience. I got some 25,000 or 20, I don't know, who they were there. But all those 200 people who were sitting there, none of them had read a single novel of mine. And they gave me, abhi batao, kya khushi hoti hai mere mein. Why le to liya, I say, because I didn't refuse.
Would you like to talk a little about your own work, your own novels?
My writing, actually writing is like, for me is like prayer. don't go to temples, I don't do any much prayer, I saw thoda bahut bhagwan ko yaad kar leti hu, but rather if I'm free I will take up a pen and sit and write, because it's now 50 years that I'm in a habit of writing. So if I can write a good piece of if I'm satisfied, I don't know how the readers will react, but if I feel I've created something, I really feel very happy and satisfied. And that I carried that day today.
And in these 50 years, which novels, what novels have you written?
As I told you, mostly my novels are, of course, romance or love stories are there, but it is giving the hidden message, not very extrovertly, but pure love.
I would actually love to hear some of your work in the original and translation, if that's possible. Is it possible to do that?
Kabhi aise book to abhi hai nahi haath mein. Three verses. I wrote a book on conversation between mother and child. Mamta Julayar mujhe ko kitab hai. Wo mujhe zyada popular hai. काफी आदमी गाना साल था वो मुझे क्यों टिल टुडे पीपल व्हेनेवर एनीबॉडी विल मेंशन मी दे विल नॉट स्पीक लेस अबाउट राइट लेस अबाउट माय अदर फिक्शन बट अबाउट दैट वाज अ फ्री वर्स एंड आई जस्ट रोट विदाउट आई मीन इन अ टोटल स्टेट ऑफ अनकॉन्शियसनेस मुझे पता ही नहीं था मैं क्या लिख रही हूँ. So that was accepted.
That is said to be the best kind of writing.
Yeah, anyathai maanu mamta julayundi gal kanda enunji. They take talk less about my after work. I have written so much, but this should come first. Koi bhi mera naam lega na, to pehle aapko ye batayega ki kala jo mamta julayu payo thi. Other things theek hai. The title is Marat of your Choti Patti. Mukhe kari pai hui, jo tama baabe je vicham me pias. Marat of your Choti Patti. Muta to te kyaas kare, kani inna ke halki chamma thai. Mukhe je kal ho je ha, ta tinde kumbal man na ke chota pochandi. Ta maati vicham me pama. Jaa, chu maat maat kare vethe hain, jeen paane school gyo. ये मोगी मोगी थी पेपरी नरान करण वहीं नंदाय बजे दादा जे थाली में गिट्टी खाए नतीजे नंदरन चप्पन से मूर्ख आई नतीजे गुलन जरन पेरन में नच नच आई नतीजे नंदरन नेरन नीरन नेरन में चम्मक आई माँ पान पे मुंझा हरा न चमा अजला जे इनके छात हुआ है उल्का पे पचायो दुआई अच्छी पुटिया ते मुकु आये पूछू मैं आई छो सुबह लाकर दिल में संभाल दर्द अखरन में होते चाहे तो शरीर के छो मारो बस चाहिए थी रूह में चुटकियाँ कद मुझी दिल भी रोई दिनों मुखे जे कल हो जे हा तो तुझे कोमल मन के चोट पहुँचंदी तो माँ थी विच में पवा मुखे कैरी पई हुई जो तमाम बाबे जे विच में प्यास मर्द पे चोटी पटी पुलिंग द प्लेट ऑफ द सिस्टर. So the mother reacts. She is saying, I didn't know that you like it, otherwise I would not have slapped him. I thought he is troubling you. I didn't know that your tender mind will feel hurt. Since morning I am finding you so quiet. Since your brother has left for school, you are looking so dull. Neither you are going for playing, nor you are like a charter, and then you see, you know.
Kin?
Grow, grow.
House?
Car, mania to grow.
A bite.
A bite. Neither you had a bite from your that food. Neither there is smile on your small lips. Neither your feet that are as tender as flowers. Neither there is any happiness in them. Your small eyes are full with tears. I am confused. Every time I am telling myself, what has happened to her? When I was baking the chapatis, you came from behind and started hitting me at the back. I said, why? Since morning you were having so much pain in your heart that you put in the verse, you told me, why did you beat my brother, Shri? Tears came in my eyes also. Had I known I am hurting your tender mind, I would not have come in between you and your brother. Let him pull your hair. I let him pull your plate.